Today we will discuss the development of embryo. Development of embryo. Inside embryo sac or female gametophyte, that is embryo sac or female gametophyte, both are synonyms. Either embryo sac or you may call it female gametophyte. After fertilization, the egg cell fertilized with male gamete, it becomes a diploid, and that is called zygote. That is called zygote. And this zygote develops into embryo. Develops into embryo. First of all, a scientist named Hans Tien. Hans Tien in 1840, studied the development of embryo in a plant named Capsella. Capsella versa pastoris. Capsella versa pastoris. In Hansen in 1840 studied first of all development of embryo in Capsella versa pastoris. It is a wild plant of family Cruciferae or Brassicaceae. The first division in the zygote, which is diploid, first division is mitosis. Mitosis, and it forms two cells. The smaller cell toward the calendar. Small cell known as apical cell, and the larger cell toward the micropylar end. Micropylar end is called basal cell. That is called apical cell and that is called basal cell. The first division in diploid zygote is mitosis. It forms two cells. One is smaller cell toward the central end, which is called apical cell, and the larger cell toward the micropylar end, it is called basal cell. After that, the small cell, which is lies at the central end, it undergoes division longitudinal division, which is also called anticlinal. Longitudinal division, whereas the basal cell undergoes transverse division, which forms 7 to 10 cells. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. All are transverse. Transverse division. And forms 7 to 10 cells. Where the apical cell, longitudinal division, again, the second division is also longitudinal, but at the right angle of the first division. It means it forms four cells. First division is longitudinal, and second division is also longitudinal, but perpendicular to the previous division. First division is like this. and secondary cell is like this. So it forms 8 cells, 4 cells. It is called quadrant. Quadrant. Quadrant means a group of 4 cells. Where the basal cells continue divide to form transversally. All division are transverse. There are 7 to 10 cells. And the last cell of that is called suspension. That is called suspension, which is formed by the continuous transverse division of larger cell or basal cell, which is like at the microcurrent end. All divisions are transverse, or these divisions are makes 7 to 10 cells. The last cell of the suspensor becomes swollen, and it is called haustoria. It is called haustoria, which get nutrition, which suck or get absorb the nutrition from the endosperm and outside the endosperm, such as mucilage or integument also. So it is now clear that the first division has 2 cells. One is smaller cell and another is larger cell. The embryo is developed from the smaller cell. This is now divided longitudinally to make 2 cells, and again longitudinally but perpendicular to the first division made 4 cells. While the larger cells continually divide transverse and it makes 7 to 10 cells. And the last cell of the suspensor becomes swollen, and it is called haustoria, which absorb nutrition from the endosperm, from the mucilage, and so on. Now the quadrant of the which is formed from the apical cell divide perineally. They are transverse, or it forms 8 cells. It forms 8 cells. It forms 8 cells. It forms a cell. And it is called octant. Octant is a group of 8 cells. 4 cells are at the outer side and 4 cells are inner side. This division from the 4 cells is a transverse division. Transverse division. Again, this group of 8 cells divide transversely and make 16 cells. Make 16 cells. In which 8 cells are inner side and 8 cells are outer side. 8 cells are outer side. Whereas this larger cell, which is at the microcurrent end, make a suspensor. Now it is clear that the embryo is formed only from the smaller cells, which is called apical cell, and present at the tail end. Now the embryo becomes round cell. The process of development of embryo in both monopod and dipod is same up to this period. A, B, C, D, E, and F. All the development of monopod and dipod embryo is the same up to this stage. But a slight difference after that. Now the embryo becomes round shape. After that, here the process of development of monopod and dipod is same, but a slight difference occurs in between the development of monopod embryo and dipod embryo. After that, in dipod embryo, the sides of the cells of this side and this side develop rapidly, but the cells present in this side, they are developed slowly, either do not develop. The two layer of cells, one is outer side, is called dermatogen, which makes outer covering of the embryo. The 16 cells present outside, 8 cells outside and 8 cells inner side. These 8 cells which is present outside are called dermatogen, and it forms outer covering of embryo, whereas the inner 8 cells form, number 1, hypocotyl, number 2, ground tissue, and number 3, procambium system. These three structures are formed from the inner 8 cells. After that, the cells which are present at the side, they divide rapidly, but the cells in between the cells are divided very less or not. Now, these cells are divided and makes 2 cotyledons. In case of these cells are not divided, these are present here, and the cells of this side divides rapidly and makes cells. These are found 2 cotyledons. So in the dicot, these are called cotyledon. One cotyledon and another one. It is in case of dipod or dicotyledon. This nodule here, the cells in this is called plumule. The cells lies just above the suspensor, it is called hypophysis, which forms radical. This is called hypophysis, and it forms the radical. These cells are called plumule, which after germination it forms shoot. And the middle cells are called embryonic axis. That is in the case of dicotyledon. The development of process from here to here is the same in monopod and dipod, and after that in dipod the cells of sides or lateral cells divide rapidly, but middle cells do not divide. It forms two cotyledons. The nodes where the cells do not develop, that is called plumule, which develop into shoot, and the base just before the suspensor, these cells are called hypophysis, and it develop into radical. And in between the plumule and radical, that is called, these cells are called embryonic axis. The cotyledons are just lateral to from the embryonic axis. But in case of monopod, there is only one cotyledon. Such as in wheat, rice, maize, bajra, all are monopods. Monopods. that is called endosperm. Endosperm, and it is covered by a layer of protein. This protein layer is called aleurone. Aleurone and the serine structure. Below this, monocotyledon is present. And after that, the embryo is present. That is called plumule, and that is called polyotyle. That is called radicle, and that is called polioriza. Polioriza. And this saline structure, that is called cotyledon. So in monocot, there is only one cotyledon, and in dicot, there are two cotyledons are present. This cotyledon is present inside the embryo sac or ovule like this. That is ovule, outer integument, inner integument, nucellus, embryo sac, and the embryo. Like this. Micropyle. Calyza, outer integument, inner integument, nucellus, embryo sac, and that is called embryo. Ye cotyledon or these are suspensor and host cell. So this type of development of embryo in dicot and this type of polygon in monocot. The cells, if we took the example of gram, Sisal arachnum, you will find after that there are two cotyledons, that is plumule, embryonic X, that is radical, that is plumule, and that is called embryonic axis, and there are two cotyledons. That is the embryo inside the Sisal arachnum shield, which is called dicot, and it is suspensor. The cells present in between plumule and cotyledon. These are called epicotyle. The cells which are present in between the plumule and cotyledon, it is called epicotyle. And the cells which are present below the cotyledon and in between the radical, it is called hypocotyle. And that is embryonic axis. Now, development of seed. Development of seed. After fertilization, the ovule matures into seed. It means seed is the mature ovule. After fertilization, ovule matures into seed. The changes in the ovule during the formation and development of seed, the outer integument becomes enzyme, which is hard, is called testa. also called testa. Number two, interintegument, which is a thin, it is called testament. Tegment. That is called tegment. Outer integument becomes hard and from the outer coat of seed is called tegment. Also called outer coat of seed, which is hard, is called testa. Inner integument becomes thin and is called tegment. Inner coat. Inner coat. New cells consumed by developing embryo. So it is almost finished. But in case of black pepper and sugar beet, in most of the agricultural plant, during the development of seed after fertilization, outer integument becomes hard and is called enzyme, the outer coat or testa. Inner integument becomes tegument, inner coat. And new cells almost consumed by embryo, developing embryo. In some cases, new cells remains like a thin covering in black pepper and sugar beet. This remaining thin covering of new cells is known as perisperm. Perisperm. It is not present in all of the eggplant, but in some, such as black pepper and sugar beet, it is present in the form of a thin membrane. It is called perisperm. Number four, the tissue developed and modified, but no change in hilum, no change in funiculus, no change in rapi, no change in rapi and chalaza. Micropyle remains as a pore from which the seed, from that is called micropyle. It remains like as a pore from which the germinating seed get water and oxygen. So micropyle just remains like a pore, and the antipodal cells get degenerated, synergids also get degenerated, and zygote develop into embryo, and primary endosperm cells or nucleus it gets into the endosperm. So the changes in the ovule to become a seed: outer integument, inner integument, new cells almost consumed or remain as a thin membrane as in black pepper or sugar beet, it is called perisperm. No change in hilum and funiculus. Funiculus now called seed stalk. Now it is called seed stalk. Seed stalk. And no change in rapi and chalaza. And micropyles becomes a small pore from which the germinating seed absorbs water and oxygen. So it is development of seed. According to presence of endosperm in seed, presence or absence, seeds are two types. Number one, non-endospermic seed, and number two, endospermic seed. Number one, non-endospermic seed. Those seeds which has no endosperm. It means endosperm has been consumed. like no endosperm, because the endosperm is totally consumed by developing embryo. No remains endosperm. The example are most dicot plants have this type of seeds. And another is called endospermic seed. Those seeds which have endosperm as a remains after the development of embryo. It means embryo has been completely developed. Embryo has been completely developed. But endosperm remains. Such type of seeds are called endospermic seed. Most monocot plants have this type of seeds. Yani besides the development of embryo, the endosperm remain in some amount. So these are called endospermic and most monocot plants. But here endosperm has completely consumed by developing embryo, so endosperm is not remains in most dicot plants. There are some exceptions in dicot plants which has endosperm, or there are some exceptions in monocot which has not endosperm. But most of the dicot plants have non-endospermic, and most of the monocot plants have non-endospermic seed. Now, fruit. What is fruit? The fruit is a ripened ovary. Ripened ovary. It means the fruit is developed from the ovary. The definition of fruit is simple. Fruit is a ripened ovary. After fertilization. That is called thalamus, calyx, corolla, stamen, and carpel, ovary, style, and stigma. Inside the ovary, these are ovules. After fertilization, the ovules becomes seed. Ovules matures and becomes seed. So, seed is the mature ovule. And ovary becomes fruit. Ovary becomes fruit. These are the changes inside the flower. But the outer, the calyx disappeared, shrinks and disappeared, shed off, gir jate hain, jhad jate hain, shed off, shivered and shed off, corolla shed off, stamen shed off, style and stigma also shed off. After fertilization, all the floral parts, calyx, corolla, endosium, style and stigma get shivered and shed off from the plant, and only the pedicel, thalamus, ovary, and ovules are present. Ovules now matures into seeds, and ovary becomes fruit. So we can say that the fruit is a ripened ovary. Now the types of fruits. Fruits are generally two types. Number one, true fruit, and number two, false fruit. True fruit and false fruit. True fruit, those fruits which are developed directly from the ovary. Yani, during the formation of fruit, only ovary takes part. As I have already told you, inside the ovary, these are now developed into seeds. Ovule into seeds, where the ovary becomes fruit. During the development fruit from the ovary, two hormones. Number one is auxin and number two is gibberellin. These hormones produced in the ovary and it develops into fruits. That is good. So those fruits which develop direct from the ovary are called true fruits, such as mango. Our vegetables, such as gourd, bitter gourd, tomato, all are true fruits because they develop directly from the ovary. Another false fruit. Those fruits in which along with ovary, the other floral parts also take part to form the fruits, such as calyx, such as thalamus. It means the fruit developed from ovary, calyx, thalamus, and other parts of the flower, then it is called phallus. Here only ovary becomes fruit, and here along with ovary, calyx and other parts of the flower also take part in the formation of fruit. So that is called phallus fruit. The best example of that is apple or walnut. These are phallus fruit. Once again, the fruits develop after the fertilization. Mostly the fruits develop after the fertilization, but in some cases such as banana, such as grapes, such as papaya, the fruits also develop without fertilization. Now I repeat, mostly the fruits develop after fertilization from the ovary, but in some cases fruits develop in banana, grapes or papaya from the ovary without fertilization. So this type of fruits are called parthenocarpic fruit. And this type of fruit do not contain seed, because fertilization is not occurred. These fruits develop without fertilization from the ovary, without fertilization. So these fruit do not contain any seeds. And such type of fruit are called parthenocarpic fruit, and this process is known as parthenocarpy. The development of fruit without fertilization from the ovary is called parthenocarpy, and such type of fruits are called parthenocarpic fruit. These are also of two types. Number one, natural, and number two, artificial. Natural or artificial, it is also known as induced. Not as induced. Natural, in nature, such as in banana, the ovary becomes fruit. Ovary becomes fruit naturally. Naturally, so it is called natural parthenocarpy. Natural parthenocarpy. But when the parthenocarpy is motivated or induced by the scientist, by the farmers, by the researchers, with the help of auxin and gibberellin, then it is called artificial or induced parthenocarpy, as in papaya, as in grapes, as in navel santra. This is done by when the by spraying, by dusting two hormones, auxin and zibelin, on the stigma. These hormones move toward the ovary and motivated to become fruit without fertilization. This is done by artificially, so it is called artificial or induced parthenocarpy. And in banana, it is a natural process. So in parthenocarpy fruit, there is no seed. So the economic value is very much rather than other fruit. Now, it is last to complete this lesson. A small thing is also remaining, which is called alternation of generation, which we studied already in first chapter. So, in angiosperm plant, which is two end, and called sporophyte, which is long limbed, and it is root, stem, leaves, stem and leaves. So this sporophyte alters by the gametophyte, which bears pollen grains, and here female gamete or egg cell. After fertilization, pollen grains makes male gamete. These are end. After fertilization, zygote is formed, which is also sporophyte. So, in angiosperm plant, alternation of sporophyte and gametophyte is altered by linear rotations, just as day or night. Huh. But in case of sporophyte, it is long lived, it is self making food in autotrophs, while the gametophyte depends on sporophyte for their survival. So it is called alternation of generation. It is now the chapter is complete. You must make notes and read.